Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and here we are, Aviation. I'm your lead commentator, Brad Maple, and I'm joined by...
Hey, Michael, as always, and we are coming off a great way to start the night with the pre-show and leading right into what's no doubt going to be a very drama-filled episode, as always. And it looks like this time we're going to be greeted by the boss lady herself, Tiffany Arrow, who we have been informed prior to this on social media has a big announcement for us. So,
I'm not going to expect anything less than a big announcement like is planned from our chairwoman of the board coming out here. You know, as we talked about, look at her dress. She's looking beautiful.
Boys and girls from far and wide, welcome to my show. I know all of you have been sitting on the edge of your seats, anticipating just when I was going to make a formal appearance to properly run over everything there is to know about Aero Academy. Now, the wait is over. For those of you who are not familiarized with our show's history thus far, can I just ask what you're doing here now? Talk about piss poor attention spans, losers. Anyways, back to business. This is Aero Academy's first major CPV, otherwise known as Aviation. How exciting! I don't get that amped up over much nowadays, but this is the perfect occasion to celebrate. Now, tonight, I have entrusted a much larger selection of my talents to showcase their absolute best. As you all know, I like to keep things to a minimum, short and sweet. It's much more enjoyable that way. So it would make no sense for me to throw all I have up my sleeve out in the public eye at once. After all, I do have to keep a close eye on everyone and things. That, unfortunately, brings me to my big announcement for the evening. I am a very busy woman in the sense I am the chairwoman of the board, naturally. I deal with things half of you don't even know exist behind the scenes. To ensure things run as smooth as possible, this means my attention cannot always be honed in on the students as required for their maximum improvement and performance. It is with great displeasure that I am going to proclaim the board has persisted in pinpointing and assigning a full-time general manager to sit in and keep things afloat while I handle business away from the business. Before I say the name, just know this was far from the one I originally put in the ballot to be voted for. So this has zero reflection on me if anything happens to go sour down the line. Come on out, Cassius. Let's hurry up and get this over with so I don't have to look at that repulsive smirk. I am no doubt am certain you have on your face at this very moment. Hurry up. Come on. Oh. Get out here.
Cassius?
Wait, what?
That's, a curveball, to say the least. I'm not exactly, sure how we're supposed to take this news, but, if anybody's ecstatic, it's gotta be this guy.
Wait, this guy. This guy's the general manager. And I watched this man brutally beat up Aiken Arrow. I've seen this man destroy people across the circuit and on cherish the opportunity. Wait, you're telling me this guy? This guy? No.
Well, you know, on any given day, I'd say, why not give the guy a chance, but he doesn't exactly look dressed to the part for his first night on the job. So...
I, Yeah, he looks like... Was he on vacation? In Hawaii? Like...
Maybe we'll find out now. Who knows?
Don't act so upset, baby. You know that everyone loves to see Big Cassius in any type of way. And hey, you might get a chance to see why a lot of ladies do too, but... with the sexual harassment policy I reluctantly agreed to, you and I will just have to wait.
Trust me, that is absolutely nothing I am losing sleep over.
Anyways, that's not the point. I've been brought in to be the new general manager of Aero Academy because I am known to be, and I quote, have the best young mind today. And have the tenacity to bring not only Aero Academy, but the wrestling business into the future.
Young mind, I wouldn't say all of that now.
You don't believe me? Throughout my career, I am known to be a force to be reckoned with. But I am also considered the most forward thinker in this business. Hell, I'm even for equality for women. In fact, I was in the first intergender match in CTO history. It was an honor for that young, untalented woman to get into the ring with a living legend like myself. The way I won might have been, how do you put it, discouraged by some of the audience. And most company owners. But I can assure you that I am a peaceful person at heart, and that this will not affect my work ethic.
Barely.
Listen, sweetie, I know you're trying to act like a grown-up and act all tough in front of a man like me as you interrupt me, but maybe let your new general manager speak to the people right here in Los Angeles, California. Because, like that one mediocrely famous black guy says, I feed off this energy from the crowd, and they make me give my best each and every night.
And let me just remind you whose last name is at the forefront of this very company's trademark, Cassius. That's right, Arrow. I am the chairwoman of this company, and I could care less what you think. I could care less what the rest of the board members think. I could care less if they want you here or not. I will not hesitate to relieve you of your duties at my will. So watch your mouth, and do not step out of line again.
You got a feisty side to you then. All right. I'll just let this lie down for a little bit, but you and I aren't done yet. But anyways, I am more than qualified for this position. In this year alone, I finished an entire online class in business marketing while also binge-watching the show Suits on the USA Network. So you could say I know a little thing or two in how to handle a company. Which brings me to tonight. When it comes to a pay-per-view, you need an amazing main event. And that's exactly what we have tonight with Sean O'Reilly versus Lassiter versus Scotty. Even though I hate all of these men, I know they will give you a show. But I think it needs a little more. So ladies and gentlemen, tonight in our triple threat main event, it will now be for the newly debuting Aero Academy Grand Championship. And with that, I now know that this show will be just too sweet.
I am woman enough to admit that is one of the only remotely acceptable things that has ever left your lips. Ever. Up until the very last part. But I'm just going to pretend that wasn't accompanied with the rest. You heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen. There will not be just one, but two inaugural championship matchups this evening. At this point, you have all seen just what our coveted Divas Championship looks like. So stay tuned as we prepare to reveal just what our three special superstars for this evening will be fighting for. Without further ado, let's get the show started. Ew! Don't touch the freak.
I guess that's our cue. Okay.
I'm feeling a lot of things right now, Kane.
Yeah, there was a roller coaster of topics and conversations that just underwent. But as we try and get our, you know, focus back on track here, we're looking to get things started with our first matchup of the evening. And I actually don't know who is competing in this matchup besides, you know, of course, Takana as she makes her way out here, who has more recently been, well, really, as always, when we see this woman just unleashing her just ill will on anybody thrown in her path.
Yeah, we're going from one interesting individual in Cassius to another one now with Takana. And we're not really sure who she's facing tonight, but I gotta be worried for whatever woman's gonna be stepping in the ring with her.
I gotta be more worried for whoever, I gotta be more worried for Takana. I mean, if someone's got, you know, the courage to kind of willingly step up against her, then, I guess that's to give a little credit where it's due, in a sense.
That is true.
We'll see. I'm excited to find out. Well, if it isn't about time, this woman decided to make herself known here. But against Takana?
Violetta!
Against Takana, though, that's, not... Oh!
Oh!
A bit of a reveal here. I was just about to say... Takana? That's who you wanna... That's who you want to, kind of get started with here?
I don't really know what this woman's thinking. Get into the ring with a woman like Takana, but I don't really know what to think.
I mean, I guess all power to her, but, you know, I hate to be the type to try and judge a book by its cover, but putting the two side by side, yeah, it's night and day.
Yeah, it looks like she should be going to a cabaret party instead of a wrestling match. Here we are.
That's kind of what I figured. Maybe she's having some second guesses here.
It looks like she's upset. It's Akana chasing her.
Oh, yeah, she's definitely going to make her paper. Oh! Deciding to show up, if it was even a good idea at all. Oh! Stomping on the face there. Takana wasting no time here whatsoever.
Only a one count, though, and Violetta quickly getting up and getting met with a huge elbow and now a kick.
God,
a huge enziguri.
God, you can just see how fast Takana just lands all of her strikes. Ooh, a two count there. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the sense got knocked into Violetta. Gotta be wondering what she thought it was a good idea or not to pop up here tonight.
Just a huge elbow now by Violetta, and clubbing blow to the back of Takana, and Well, she already thinks that she's already won this. Already just dusting their hands off.
Yeah, that's a little bit of offense here. Probably not as effective as she thinks it probably is in her head, but at least she's confident. Oh, God!
Huge high leg kicks by Violetta, and all just trying to choke her out now.
God, using that high advantage there, as you can see the long legs of Violetta coming into play for those vicious strikes in the corner. Pinfall here. Ooh, pretty close two count here. Well.
It looks she's just somehow getting the best of Dakana. She goes for the pin again, and
God.
That was close.
That vicious big boot. Let's take another look at that one.
Wow, that was just a vicious big boot while Dakana was down. She didn't even see that coming.
That all set her rocking all the way back, but in a live action. Dakana easily turning that around with the thrust kick to the gut.
Oh, but she's got to watch over the long legs from Violetta. You know, that's going to be hard. If she gets a big move off, she's going to have to pull her to the middle of the ring.
Oh, looks like some kicks of her own, maybe giving her a taste of her own medicine here. She's back up to the corner. Yep. Oh, now choking her. Just as Violetta did to her moments ago.
Oh, my God. I do not want to mess with that woman's
arm. Oh, God. A calf
single
kick.
Leg drop kick. What's a play? A little possum. I don't think that move even hurt her, but she's got
handful
the hair.
Of hair. Oh!
Uppercut
to the head. Oh, and right on top of her here. Surfboard, it looks like. With the face crusher edition.
Yeah, just slamming her face right into the canvas. And she's staying on top right now. That's smart. Look at her just dig that knee right into the back of the Kana with this modified camel clutch.
As you can see, she's got that 1 foot planted in the ground. Able to use her height here to really add some leverage on that one. The quickness of Dakana.
Yeah, that was really quick by the corner of the ground.
Right on the moneymaker there. Drop toe hold. A little bit of an assist with the arm wrench. Only a one count, though.
Only a one count. We got an octopus stretch now. Or no, maybe an abdominal stretch. Excuse me, by Dakana. Is looking at just trying to pull that arm out of the socket.
Yeah, and just tugging back on the long abdomen there of Violetta. She lost her grip maybe a little bit there, as I was just briefly mentioning the height difference. Oh, but right back into it she goes.
Going right forward again. Violetta saw this one coming this time.
Ooh.
Trying to get some punches and a huge press.
God, hip toss taking her right over. A bit of a strength display there. I don't know if it's pure strength or maybe just the height there really coming into play. Knees to the chest, taking Dakana down.
Oh, yeah, there's some definite height on that knee by Violetta. Is now
a bit of a amorous display, to say the least. Oh, God!
Wow.
The intensity there. Oh, that's new, definitely. I wasn't expecting a display such as that from Violetta, but effective, very much so. When it counted,
a huge elbow again by Dakana.
Oh gosh, she's just taking it to her, clearly not appreciating the disrespect at all here.
Huge spear!
Taking her down. Oh god, and a primal scream to follow. Well, one count though, maybe not as effective as it appeared, but it still wears Violetta down enough to say the least. Oh! Punch the gut there, but it gets some space between the two. Stiff kick there from Violetta.
Yeah, with the pin now. It's only a two count.
Yeah, that was a close fall for Violetta there.
Talk about an upset. If Violetta is able to beat Dakana on our debut match here, this is going to be very interesting.
Yes, it definitely is going to be, but Takana's going to make her work for it, that's for sure. Handful of hair sending her all the way across the ring.
Somehow Takana was able to just throw around the huge height advantage. huge exploder.
God, sitting here across the ring once again, throwing her around here to Kana, not letting such a thing as height difference play here. Oh!
Missile. Hit her that with a huge missile drop kick. It looks like she got it right in the head.
God, it looks like she set her up here. Perfect positioning. Top rope here.
And oh! Elbow drop. And Kana with the pin.
Hot.
Wait, what the?
Oh no. Juliana! God, a ref distracted here, as you can see by Violetta once again with her amorous tendencies. And Takana, you can count to however long you want. Oh!
Huge bicycle kick by Violetta.
Coming right down the back of the head. 2, 3. Oh! A little bit of an assistance there from the company and Juliana, but either way, Violetta has done what's virtually the impossible, and she won!
I can't believe it. I
have a feeling that this may probably be something that Violetta grows to regret down the line, especially with who was involved. Good luck to her.
Yes.
Good luck.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen, to Aviation. If you're just tuning in, you missed a very interesting introduction to Cassius as our general manager, the debut and first win of Violetta, and now we have the dangerous Marcella making her way to the ring.
Yes, and this woman is really a force to be reckoned with in her own right here in Aero Academy. Her luck has been very wish-washy. But, you know, as we know her, she is a comeback queen, and I would love to say I'm on her side tonight, but her opponent may just be, it's a task for Marcella, to say the least, and, jump on.
Oh, you know exactly it, but... You know, Marcella, you know, she's been in dogfights like this before, and I don't think she isn't going to quit quickly in this matchup.
Yes, I don't believe. She's definitely perseverant, to say the least, you know. And if I do recall correctly, Marcella is actually one of the two only women who have ever been able to get a pinfall over Kyung. So she probably has a lot more confidence than, you know, we can imagine, but... You know, no matter how many wins you get over someone like this, I don't think it gets any easier. At all.
Here she is, Kyung Han, one of the most dangerous forces in women's wrestling today.
Oh yeah, just whenever you hear that name, you better be ready to run for cover or put your hands up for a fight, because she's got it all. The speed, the height, the striking capability, the grappling.
The strength.
You name it, she has it. And dare I say, and I hope for whoever she ends up facing when it happens, she doesn't have some high-flying capabilities in her, because that would be the icing on the cake for her very large arsenal of maneuvers she can use to put somebody away. All business is always the intense stare of Kyung here, and now her attention is solely on Marcella, who is definitely not on her best side.
Oh, no, exactly. You know, these two have been going at it now for episodes now, and that this is going to finally, hopefully, be the blow-off between these two individuals.
Oh! God, strikes right out the gate here from Kyung, taking it straight to Marcella.
Oh, no, this is not good already. Throwing her around it.
Oh!
She's going for a belly-to-belly, but Marcella taken down.
Oh! God! See, maybe that experience with her might have come into play here. She was able to kind of tie herself around Kyung to prevent that belly-to-belly from connecting. Well, kick to the shoulder.
Bouncing off the rope. Single leg drop kick.
God, going head first into this one, and that's just how you're going to do it, to take it to someone like Kyung. A one count, though. You can see she's just shoving Marcella off with ease every single time.
Exactly.
Schoolgirl.
Wait. Schoolgirl powerbomb.
God, just like that. Oh, yeah. I don't blame
Marcella
her.
Marcella's showing off her experience.
And right there on the ropes, very impressive display there from Kyung. However, Marcella definitely doing the wiser and saving her energy from kicking out.
Wow.
God,
that was just a straight punch.
Straight punch, close fist and all. Oh!
Yeah, we got a discus punch now. It's taking out Marcella again. And
oh, yeah.
She has to be dazed.
Yeah, she definitely has got to be second-guessing where she currently is. And, that place being in the corner right now. And she definitely does not want to be here with her.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Jesus, the fury of punches by Kyung. Honestly, brutalizing her face. And, choking her out with the...
So Raph doing what he can, but I don't blame him for not getting too close to Kyung. God, she's just intimidating as it gets. Let's take a look at that once again.
Oh, just look at this. We're gonna see the bruises start to like accumulate on the face of Marcella after all those punches.
Oh yeah, it's definitely going to be something that she's gonna be feeling later on tonight, no matter the outcome, if it doesn't get added on to. Kyung, as expected, is really just laying it into it here with Marcella.
Kyung bounces it all. Balls go flying over the ropes.
Kyung able to catch herself, though, as she was anticipating that, I'm certain, with the speed she had going into that.
Just throwing Marcella to the ropes. I mean, the barricade, excuse me.
Hitting her
with an uppercut. No.
God, poor Marcella just getting dragged around into the barricade by her feet there.
I gotta start feeling bad for her. I know this is a wrestling match, and you know, obviously it's gonna be brutality, but Kyung is just completely brutalizing Marcella in this matchup.
She really is. Oh! Going for the patent double axe handle. Marcella able to scout it, though. Roll up here, too. And the schoolgirl doesn't quite get the job.
She almost snuck out a victory.
Leaping there.
Huge jumping neck breaker. Marcella showing off that athletic ability. And
up she goes here.
If we're on the top rope. Huge missile drop kick.
And it does the job, taking her down here too.
No.
This is not a drill. This is not a false alarm. This shit is for real. Baby, I'ma love you now.
This is not a drill.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the main show of Aviation. And if you're just now, you know, getting yourself situated to join us this evening, Marcella is not having the greatest of evenings, as Kyung, as you can see, is just in firm control all throughout the commercial break.
Oh, yeah, no, I, oh, wait. Marcel's in a bad predicament. Or was it? Find a way to fight out of it. Ooh, just going to the top rope again.
Oh, no. Kyung not letting her have a moment to breathe or get herself together.
Wait.
Oh!
Huge belly to belly off the top rope.
Oh, a two count, though. Somehow, Marcella able to get out of that one. It's all that weight came crashing down onto her with that belly to belly.
Wow, that was a really close two count. Wow.
That definitely was. Oh, God, these uppercuts.
Yeah, just pushing Marcella back the entire length of the ring.
Oh, God.
And, the referee has to check up on her now.
Yes, dropped one knee there. Oh!
Oh my god!
Oh god, Marcella somehow staying in this, but at this point, I wonder if she should just maybe just stay down or forfeit because Kyung is just laying it into her. Oh! Oh no.
Oh.
Oh no, we've seen her use this before!
Oh my god, we got the cross-faced chicken wing applied now, the modified sleeper hold.
Oh god, I think Marcella's hand has touched the rope! But the ref is literally behind them, he can't exactly see what's going on!
Yeah, I think, yeah, she's touched the rope twice now, three
times! Oh no, and it looks like it doesn't make a difference here for Marcella, and the ref just blind to what was going on the opposite side of Kyung. You know, I don't know if it was intentional or not, that she was maybe blocking his view, but it definitely ended up in her favor. And Marcella just...
I don't know, we have to question this. Is Marcella, we saw she clearly touched the rope.
Thank you, King. Tammy here again. Now with what they would call themselves the hottest tag team in wrestling, Scott and Lassiter, who are both going to be competing tonight for the newly announced Grand Championship. You two are opponents in this match. What exactly can we expect to be the outcome of this, when there's only supposed to be one winner?
I mean, we are a tag team. So, technically, we both equal, like, what, one whole person? Which means, if we both pin him at the same time, then we both win the gold. Boom. Logic.
Then they'll so have to give us the world title, and we'll be like champs together. It's going to be so hot that we'll be the first ever bro champs. And everyone, I mean everyone, knows my past with Grandpa Old Riley. He isn't on my level or even on Scott's. He wishes he can match up to just our awesomeness alone, but he never will. He's simply just another happy-go-lucky sperm cell that just sits around leeching onto my hotness. Like, come on, we've seen this movie before, and it's called Everyone Wants to Be Extremely Explicit. Down to our totally hot fashion looks, and all the way to simply just because of our looks, they want to be us. Why? Because we are the next biggest tag team on the map.
Look, someone like Sean doesn't deserve that title. He'll just bore the crowd with another boring title run that no one will care about and will eventually lose interest for. Then, people will stop tuning into Aero Academy because of him. And that's just bad for business, you know?
Look, when Lass and I both win that title tonight, and become bro champs, we will save Aero Academy from ever becoming, you know, boring and dried out. Like Sean.
Look, we already break hearts. Now we're about to break records of being not only the first ever grand champions, but being the first ever tag team to hold a belt together.
God, this could be something big here. Oh!
Oh, a huge knee again! What's going on? The lights are out.
What? I don't.
What's going on?
I guess some sort of technical. Okay. I don't know what happened, ladies and gentlemen. Who's this? seemingly after the brief power outage, this man has appeared out of nowhere to, I don't know, to Skylar's aid, I guess? Whatever he just signaled for brought a life to Skylar we hadn't seen this entire time.
Frankly, I don't know what's going to be able to put these two men away.
Oh, wait, what?
Oh.
I did previously mention that he had a twin.
I guess we call that some twin magic by the monster twins.
Well. Sorry, guys. This was a misunderstanding.
I don't make the decision.
Oh, right. I couldn't help but notice the issues you've been having.
So how about a bit of an alliance?
What's this? Well, ladies and gentlemen, it has appeared that we have reached one of our highlight matches for this evening, and as you all just saw from that recap, oh my god, okay. It's gotten, intense. As intense as that, even.
Here they come. And we finally have a name for this group, the pack. It very much goes with their mentality, like a pack of wolves just going after any tag team in sight.
God, and just looking at them, you kind of know what they're all about. There's no word that just comes to mind to truly describe their presence. It is just eerie. And I don't exactly think the people that have been on the short end of the stick have really been able to figure it out either for themselves.
We still don't know why they're here or what their purpose is, besides just causing utter destruction in front of them.
Well, speaking of utter destruction, the Nazca brothers here had made their, debut very recently in comparison to some of the other people here, the last episode, the very last episode of Turbulence before arriving here at Aviation. They all arrived and just laid waste to both the pack and the Akanji twins, who were deemed unable, both of them unable to compete tonight. So that kind of just leaves the Nazca brothers to face off against the pack here, and I kind of wonder if maybe that backfired a bit on them.
Hey, yeah, I think this is definitely gonna backfire on them. We've seen the destruction the pack has done, and I don't know if the Nazca brothers want to deal with this team.
Yeah, from the looks of it, they seem to be a bit more on the eccentric side, so maybe not so much intensive as the pack, but we'll see. Definitely don't want to count anybody out. I mean, if we saw a prima donna like Violetta take Takana out. Oh, Finnick taking her right to Skylar. Oh!
Huge blunt elbow.
God, taking her straight to the floor. That definitely had to knock some second thoughts into that head of his.
Exactly, and oh, he's pulling him. Huge reverse DDT.
God, right on the back of the head and neck. He just drags him around. Oh, God.
He's just slamming his head right into the mat now. He's not done.
Oh my God, the just brute force there behind those slams.
Oh, it looks like Dio's yelling something out. I'm not sure if it's to the other member of the... What the?
That looks like the Akanji brothers,
the
by not being cleared to compete, they're making their presence known anyway. Edmund, who was not part of this matchup in support of his brothers, is...
Wait, oh, we saw a huge enziguri, and I just saw a huge chop block now.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're aware of what's... Oh, God, going on. They can't exactly stop the match to 10-2. His brother, it looks like Gray, has had enough of it, though.
Oh, yeah, Gray coming out here. And how smart this is, though.
Numbers advantage to no avail there, and he's just being stomped out.
It's, oh, my God. I just throw him into the barricade.
Oh, my God, and laying him completely out. The ref's back is turned, so I was wondering what was happening. I don't think he's aware of what's going on at all. As Gray
I don't think so either.
As Gray is a legal competitor here in this matchup. Oh no.
Wait, what the?
Oh. Okay, yep, there's
he's
the bell.
The, ring.
The match is officially over. Oh! Oh God, and that backbreaker just taking Skylar out, and now his attention turns to Finnick. Oh.
Wait.
Looks like Dio, though, turning his attention to Donnie, and... Oh!
I'm just throwing him now into the barricade, but I don't think that's gonna really hurt Dio.
Oh, yeah, not at...
Jesus, super kicks out of nowhere! And this is complete mayhem out of here!
Kick of his own!
We gotta get security out here, something to stop all these men. They're gonna tear up the arena.
This is boiling out of control. Oh, God, we saw that same. God, the fireman's carry front slam put away Noah when it was last used. And. There wasn't much of a match tonight, ladies and gentlemen, but I think it's safe to say that this has only reached its pinnacle of being far from over.
Yeah, these are some things that we're going to have to figure out.
Ladies and gentlemen, and with everything that's transpired with our previous matchup, well, what was meant to be a matchup, you know, we really can't, you know, take the time to truly try and speculate just to what that's going to end up boiling down to, as we're now for Divas Championship action. The first Divas Championship match ever.
This is going to be a big moment for either of these women in this match, becoming the first women's champion of Aero Academy.
Yeah, and you know, both of these women had to endure the onslaught of a handful of women in their respective gauntlet matches to get here, and it only really provides a true testament as to the perseverance that they both have. Aubrey being one of the first women in her gauntlet, Ashlyn being the lucky last one in hers. You know, it's all fair game here as Ashlyn now makes her way out to the ring, and it's...
Yeah, looking like a sailing in the night.
Yeah, it's just... You know, I say it all the time, just night and day between some of these competitors, and this is truly no exception, from the bright colors, the dark, seductive, even, aura that Ashlyn brings. It's... Don't let it fool you, though. Do not let it fool you. This woman right here is... Gosh, she can really lay it into you.
Oh my... Jesus! You're completely right, though, King. You know, we've had the pleasure of commentating her matches, and as much as she is seductive in her appearance, she is just as brutal and, I want to say, animalistic in her offense.
And this is what it is all for, ladies and gentlemen, the Aero Academy Divas Championship. Tonight, one of these women's careers are going to be changed virtually forever, as neither of them have had an opportunity to hold the gold anywhere they've been.
Yeah, this is going to be a big moment for either of them to see who's going to become the Divas Champion. As, oh, it looks like Aubrey's about to come run out of there. Ashlyn telling her to wait, and oh, getting a cheap shot, but now Aubrey hitting her with a huge elbow, and Ashlyn's returning the favor.
Oh,
oh,
a little bit of arrogance. Or up here
for a minute. We had a roll up, but the ref was out of position.
Yeah, terribly out of position there. It may have just cost Aubrey the matchup. Ashlyn shoving him out of the way here.
Ashlyn now upon her knee. That's what I was talking about. That just that brutal offense of Ashlyn. Just that blunt strike, just pulling Aubrey's head right down on top of her knee. And huge big boot.
God, see just the. Oh, the absolute ill intentions. Every single strike, kick, punch Ashlyn throws towards Aubrey has behind it.
Oh.
Oh.
And oh my. We're just kicking her right in the kidneys. And oh, look, just choking her right on that bottom rope.
God, absolutely no respect for Aubrey whatsoever.
Exactly. Look at her just putting her boot right across her face.
Oh, God. Nothing necessarily offensive about that. However, it would definitely get into the mind of Aubrey. Oh, God. Ashlyn, both of these women taking it to each other. Oh!
And oh, huge hurricanrana by Aubrey out of nowhere.
And a brief exchange there, taking control back once more here.
And throwing Ashlyn off the ropes, and I'll hit her with a loose-ass press, slamming her head right into the canvas.
Yeah, a little bit of a aggressive side there from Aubrey. Oh!
Yeah, ended it with a huge hurricanrana DDT. This could be... Oh, I spoke too soon. Is Ashlyn able to kick out?
Definitely so. Oh, catching Aubrey there. Oh!
Well, wait.
Oh, hurricanrana!
And
oh,
Ashlyn will reverse it, but not even a one count.
Oh, God, a kick to the head there. Handful of hair and just tosses her.
Oh, yeah, it's Ashlyn just staying right on top of the momentum that she created for herself. And, you know, this is not what you want to be in. You know, see Ashlyn rolling, but...
Oh! Looked like Aubrey was suckering Ashlyn in there, but she was all the wiser and... waited it out, and look what happened. Maybe
she completely saw what Aubrey was trying to do, and we just saw a vicious backstabber by Ashlyn, and now she keeps just going after that back now.
Yeah, anything she can get her hands on. Aubrey's...
Oh, wait.
Little bit of a fake out there.
And huge airplane spin takedown.
Well, Aubrey having a little bit of fun here, looks like. Maybe some mind games of her own. Oh!
Jesus!
God, that super stiff kick of Ashlyn there took Aubrey right down.
Wow, nothing fancy about that, just slamming Aubrey's face right into the mat.
Yeah, Ashlyn's offense is just straight to the point. Oh!
Looking for something. Arm Aubrey, oh!
Comes
out of nowhere.
God, just that Spitfire Aubrey coming out of nowhere and... Oh! No avail, though. A two count. Once again, Aubrey needing to stay on top of her because she is really not... Oh! Got anything crazy going on for another drop kick to follow there.
Aubrey is pulling Ashlyn into the center of the ring. Ooh. And all we set up a shining wizard. Oh my.
Yeah, you can see that moment of realization as to where she was. She set up that shining wizard pinfall here. Two count though. Once again, not too much has changed. Yet another close count for Aubrey over at Ashlyn. Looks like she's going to maybe try and slow down the pace a little bit here to either catch her breath or wear Ashlyn down or even maybe both.
Oh, you know, we see this with the straight jacket, you know, I guess hold applied right now. Just look at just using Ashlyn's own arms against her as she digs her knee right into the back of Ashlyn. Looks like she's getting out of it.
Oh, flips her over. Using her own momentum against her there.
And throwing her right in the corner now.
Face first in that top turnbuckle there. That didn't look too pleasant whatsoever. A handful of hair. Oh, once
just
again.
Ashlyn right, yeah, right into the boot.
Oh, looked like she was going for that PDA, public display of anarchy backbreaker once again, but Aubrey being all too wise with it at this point. Ashlyn just now drops the floor after that kick. Oh, head full of steam.
Did you see how far high she jumped up?
God, right over the top rope. I think the two bumped into the barricade, though. I don't exactly know who had it worse there with that impact, but Aubrey seems like she's okay. She's taking a moment to appreciate the fans' reaction to her incredible display there.
Exactly. Wow. I can't believe she's gotten up like as quick as she has.
Up with the top rope here, looking to continue. Oh, but maybe taking a second too long, or maybe Ashlyn was playing possum.
Oh my god.
God, a DDT right onto her head, and she landed pretty angled. That might have spelled the ending for Aubrey here. Ashlyn having no respect for the ref's call to back up. Oh my god, the torque there.
No, this is terrible, though. This match should be going on. Aubrey could have legitimately been hurt by that with the way that she landed right on her neck. This is not good at all, folks.
And you can see she's focusing on that neck regardless. Oh, Aubrey somehow, some way able to get her off of her. Maybe she just might be well enough to continue after all, or maybe it's instinct. Oh!
Hitting these huge body splashes somehow. Like we said, maybe off adrenaline.
Ooh.
Huge rocket kick.
Your combination shaves her brother Aiken here. God, and she is all hyped up here. The momentum is completely on her side. Looks like she's going to go for a pinfall here to capitalize. See if she can do any damage to her.
That was close. But only two. And we got to wonder how long Aubrey can go in this match though, after having such a dangerous move done to her.
I know. Has had it super rough here, calling for something.
Huge bulldog.
Bulldog right on Ashlyn's face, and looks like she's going to try and go up once more. Is she going to be able to land? Oh no.
Ashlyn now taking the advantage now of the loop compress.
God, absolutely no remorse here for Aubrey whatsoever. Oh no. PDA!
That has to be it.
I think Ashlyn's way too in her own head here.
This is not good. Now she finally goes to the pin.
Oh, gosh.
The ref
long
getting in position.
Pause. One, two. A two count. It was a two count. I thought it was over there.
Aubrey's still having fight in her somehow.
Ooh, pulling it out of seemingly nowhere. Ooh, catching the foot here.
Catching the foot, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, oh, she's got the guillotine in.
Oh, Ashton's down.
She's got a guillotine chokehold in.
Oh, and Ashton has nowhere to go.
She's got nowhere to go.
She's tapping. We have a Divas champion.
Oh, my. Against all odds.
Aubrey, Arrow has pulled through and is your first ever Arrow Academy Divas champion.
Against all odds, even after a vicious move like that huge pile driver DDT off the rope, and
she's in shock.
Divas champion. I think she's in shock as much as we are.
God, and albeit an amazing display from Ashlyn, Aubrey just being the better woman tonight, and she's got the gold, and as you can see, she is just absolutely elated and beyond herself.
Wow. Hey, congratulations to Aubrey Arrow.
God, you deserved it after what you've gone through here.
Oh. What?
I don't believe we were scheduled to have anybody come out.
No.
Juliana Conchi, it seems. We saw her earlier this evening help out Violetta in her efforts against Takana. She's making her way out here for reasons unknown, but I can take a wild guess.
She's already attacking Aubrey. No. Power bomb.
Right onto the back of that neck, that possibly injured neck.
Is he Austin running out here?
Oh God, Aubrey's sister Austin beelining straight to the ring.
Oh my
God, and looked like she was going for that patent spear, but was dropped right on top of her head.
And she's holding up the Divas Championship now.
We've seen her dodge any type of in-ring competition in any way she possibly can. Could this possibly be her mark she's leaving here this evening? Is Juliana coming for that title?
I think that's what she's telling us.
God, actions speak a thousand words, and with this, she might have just spoken a million. Juliana is coming for Aubrey Arrow, and she better be ready for it.
Hello, Arrow Academy Universe. Once again, it's Tammy. This time, I'm backstage alongside Sean O'Reilly, who shocked everyone with his surprise appearance on the last episode of Turbulence. So tell me, Sean, you've got a big task ahead of you. Two men, both Scott and Lassiter, are going to be in the ring with you at the same time. Do you think you can pick up the win and become the very first ever Arrow Academy Grand Champion?
You were right about one thing. I do have a big task tonight, but it's not against two men. Tonight, I'm going to be fighting two overgrown children that care more about the way they look than the way they wrestle. The reason I came to Arrow Academy was to give all of those students in the back an opportunity to fight someone with the amount of experience that I have. I'm not saying I'm the best, but I damn sure know that I have put enough experience into this business, and I have almost been in every scenario that you can count. But that's not the reason Lassiter's here. I'm not going to get into the history of him and I, but the bottom line is, he knows exactly what he's doing here, and that isn't to help out those students. He's using this company to stroke his ego and make himself feel like he's the most important individual in this business. And that just pisses me off. And for Scotty, To be honest with you, I just feel bad for him. Because he believes that Lassiter is his teacher. He believes that he's actually under his wing and, you know, he's actually helping him. But that, no. That's not what's happening at all. Lassiter's just using him as a stepping stone for his own opportunities, and that's really sad. Because he has no idea that that's happening. Before this match got changed to a championship match, my goal was to go out there and not only put on a show for those fans, but to kick both of their spray-tanned asses around this entire arena and show them what it's like to be a real wrestler. But now that we got this new Aero Academy Grand Championship on the line, I have a little bit more fighting for. Tonight, I'm going out there, still kicking both of their asses around this entire ring, hitting one of them with an American buckshot, and I'm winning that Aero Academy Grand Championship for all the guys in the back so that they will have a real opportunity to shine on this show.
Scotty Evans.
He's never really gotten the shot to really break out. Of course, Lassiter, he found something very interesting about Scotty and he's brought him under his wing.
Aiken Arrow is going to be taking on Lax from the Hulu. That's not Lax. Oh, there's the man himself. Looks like he's having a little bit of company.
My name is Aiken Arrow. What you're going to expect to see is a bunch of our students. We have
high stuff. This is our show.
Because you are fat, ugly, fast.
While we tickle like the sea still beyond. He was just like jealous of us. Because we have bodies that appeals to the eye.
And it's losers like that who deserve their house's TP.
No way, is that Sean O'Reilly?
Sean O'Reilly's right here at Aero Academy! And I expect a little more from you, Lassiter. And if you think I'm gonna put up with it, I extend a proposition to you. The three of us at Aero Academy's Aviation.
We have officially made it to the main event, ladies and gentlemen. And what a highly anticipated bout this one has really amounted itself to be. You know, we kind of have to do a little bit of a history recap here, as you all saw briefly by that video package. You know, Sean kind of just made his way about, and beforehand, the team of Extremely Explicit, as we all know them, with Lassiter and Scott, they were having a good old time picking on Aiken Arrow. And I'm not exactly sure if Sean's presence maybe has some sort of link to that. I mean, from what we heard him speak, you know, moments ago, it definitely is, you know, in his sight. You know, he's very aware of what was going on. But it's now all boiled down to a championship matchup.
Yeah, this is very interesting. Sean didn't come here for championships, as far as we know, because he came here to settle this grievance that he has seen from Extremely Explicit with the way that they've been bullying the roster, especially Aiken Arrow. And as we said, that nothing about this changes for him. He's still going to come out here and, quote, kick both their asses around this entire arena.
Yeah, quote unquote. So it's personal. You know, there's definitely, some backstory that maybe we don't know in the entire brunt of, but we do know that it is a 2-on-1 scenario virtually, and you know, and it's natural to be under the impression anything can go in a triple threat matchup.
So it's going to be a very, very interesting dynamic to see all three of these men, particularly these two, as you can see how buddy-buddy they are with one another, taking on someone as experienced and as resilient as Sean O'Reilly in a championship match of that. The stakes are as high as they could possibly be.
Well, exactly. This is going to be very interesting as Scotty and Lassiter, they're going to be teaming up against Sean, and as they said, they want to become the first, what was it, Bro Champs,
and they made sure to provide the most emphasis that they possibly could, as they said it. So, you know, I would say they're all business, but I don't think that does them justice.
No, as you can see, Sean, look at him, he's not even fazed by the way they're looking.
Not at all, as you can see, just absolutely, his attention has not wavered. In fact, I think I just see him briefly there for that moment, that his attention was specifically on Lassiter. But anyway, as you can see, that gorgeous belt that we're all seeing for the first time, the Aero Academy Grand Championship, and boy, is she a beaut.
Look at that thing. That thing is very beautiful, and we have, I guess we have Cassius to thank for this matchup.
You know, and I'm sure that is statement in itself is probably far few between.
The match isn't even underway, and Scotty just got thrown out of the ring. Huge lariat by Sean O'Reilly. Quickly going for the pin, with Scotty making his way back in here and bringing it to Sean.
Another one. Ducking underneath that clothesline and a third. Lariats for everybody here.
Huge lariat now throwing Scotty back outside of the ring.
Roll up here. Sean is on top of it tonight. Two. Just barely a two count. He is fired up.
He didn't see Scotty come back in the ring, and he's got met with a lariat of Scotty's now.
As quick as he was fired up, that fire was doused.
Huge chop block clothesline combination.
Yeah.
Extremely explicit, and Sean had no other way to roll out of the ring.
Yeah, maybe try and get a breather. Space. Yeah, I think I even saw Scott go for that brace knee, and it's definitely had a history of injuries to it. So, you know, it is very apparent that the two have some sort of game plan heading into this one.
Sean, someone finding some light now and trying to fend himself off against both of these individuals. He's giving both of them forearms and uppercuts huge uppercut that time. Lassiter now is punching Sean. He's trying to move the big frame of O'Reilly.
Finally was able to rock the big guy down. As you can see, he was just kind of taking those punches in full. I don't know if he was just purposely standing there to kind of maybe taunt Lassiter a little bit, seeing as he wasn't too much fazed by them. Either way, it took quite a lot to finally get him down.
That put down O'Reilly. Jesus Christ, that was a huge big boot by Lassiter. We see a lot from his long legs, and we got a last chance reapplied now.
Yeah, with the surfboard, with his legs tied up there again, the attention going back to the knee. So it's, that game plan is in full effect, and middle of the ring. Ooh, strength there. Sean, though, able to get out of it for now. Turning.
Jesus.
Inside. Huge. Out.
Huge clothesline out of nowhere, and Lassiter is on the outside way. Scotty with a huge one-handed bulldog a variation of a DDT just impaling Sean's face into the canvas.
As we've seen him use that once or twice before, and he was able to lock it in tonight as well on Sean, and just as effective. Irish whipping here. Sean getting the best of that exchange, though.
Scott. Bringing O'Reilly down.
Bit of athleticism there of his own.
Now he's taking a second to pander the crowd here.
That's
pushing him down. Very disrespectful by Scotty.
Looked like he was going to go for something a bit more aggressive, but I think maybe that was the whole point.
Sean O'Reilly not having any of it. We're seeing those forearms in full display. And Twister on neck breaker.
Oh, up and he goes.
He goes and oh! Landslide.
Guys, got the leg hooked too.
Close.
Got very close fall, and as you can see, this match was almost over with Lassiter nowhere to be seen. Oh, spoke too soon as he's now back up onto his feet after he was just brutalized by that one clothesline from Sean.
Throwing Lassiter right into Scott. He just taking on Extremely Explicit all by himself.
Got it, and having no issue with it whatsoever, seemingly. Lassiter out once again. Discus punch.
Huge elbow. The American Patriot.
Taking it right to him.
Only two count.
Two count once again. Not enough to keep Scott down as we take another look at how he just threw Lassiter. Yeah, I think a headbutt happened as a result of that, which sent Lassiter right out to the ringside once again.
Lassiter getting back in the ring, and another roll up by Sean, trying to pull a fast one on Extremely Explicit.
He's really trying to keep on top of the action here. He's now backed up against the ropes by Scott. Thrown into Lassiter though.
Huge Uranagi with a backbreaker at the end of it.
Lassiter showing off his strength there. Going for the pin, as you can see, Scott absolutely in no rush to try and break it up, as I think they're both under the impression it's just whoever can pin the big guy here.
Exactly. I don't think they really care who becomes the world, the grand champion of Arrow Academy, as Lassiter comes in with a huge boot across O'Reilly's face.
Yeah, that face wash doing all of the damage. As always, just taking their time and have a good time. Detention's ringside though. Lassiter went to retrieve Sean, it looked like.
Giving a huge. Right into the barricade back first. Lassiter goes.
And once again, taken down. Scott's back is turned. He is.
I don't think he sees
him.
Huge Superman punch by O'Reilly.
And Scott could be down for the rest of the night.
And he's just waiting for Lassiter to get back in. Buckshot!
That's it. That could be it. And Sean is all on fire here. It is in hit. Wait. His back is turned. He has no idea what's going on, too.
Wait. You gotta be kidding.
Scott is our grand champion.
Sean, can't believe it.
I think his reaction kind of speaks for us all when we say, what?
He didn't see. He thought he gave Scott a Superman punch that knocked him out. He thought he was going to be out. And he took a minute to look to the crowd and
no avail, and that is it. We have a new champion, and that's our show. As always, we hope you all enjoy. We shall see you all